Hi, my name is Kelvin Johnson. In this video, I'm going to show you how to enable and use unsolicited remote assistance. As an IT administrator, sometimes you may have issues or situations whereby you need to help someone who has a problem with his laptop or with his desktop PC. So in this test environment I've created, we're going to create some policies which will allow us to use unsolicited remote assistance without this group policy and also a firewall rules that will create some exception for our domain environment. The remote assistance will not work. So what I did actually in this environment, first of all, I under Active Directory users and computers, you go to server manager, and the tool there you have Active Directory users and computers. So I have created an organization unit called domain computers, and in this domain computers I created three organization units called Windows 10. In my Windows 10 environment I have two host machines which I'm going to use for this test environment, and I also have Windows 7. There I created just one host machine. For Windows 8, I don't have any destination. So if you are working in an enterprise environment, you have thousands of Windows 10 machine or hundreds of Windows 7 machine. So I also created a security group called IT Help Desk. In this group, we have a member called Thomas Johnson will actually be the only person who is allowed or has a permission to offer remote assistance to other users in this test environment. So as you can see, let me see, I'm using a virtual machine, so sometimes it may be very slow. So as you can see, I have domain users and domain units which are also created. I've an administrator as Calvin Johnson myself, at the help desk Thomas Johnson. Now for the users I have Nora Johnson. So Nora Johnson will be our client who needs assistance. So to create the policy, we need to go back to server manager, tools, and there you have group policy management. So click on group policy management, and here you see that I have all my organization unit I created in Active Directory are here in my group policy management. So now what we are actually interested about is the domain computers. So I want the policy I'm going to create is going to affect every single machine in my enterprise environment. So here we have the domain computers. So right click on the domain computers and then create a GPO in this domain and link it here. So I'm going to give my GPO a name. I called mine configure unsolicited remote system. So you can give yours any name you fit is okay for you. Click OK. Right click on that policy you just created and click edit. So now we are interested in the computer configuration, because the role I'm creating is not for the users but for the computer configuration. So first of all, you go to computer configuration, you click computer configuration, and then you click policies, then you click administrative template. Let me enlarge this so that you can see it very well. Administrative template. In administrative template, you go to system, and here we are going to look for remote assistance. There it is. So now we are only interested actually in this role, but you can also configure other roles for this for the remote assistant. But for this session, we're only interested in configure offer remote assistance. So double click on this and you click enable. And here you have allow helpers to remotely control the computer. So you have two roles, or you can also choose allow helpers to only view the computer. So for me, I'm interested more in allow helpers to remotely control the computer, because we want to view the session of the user and also take over his session. So what is actually also very, very important in this remote assistance is the helpers. Here you click show, and as you can see, now we need to place the users who will be able to offer remote assistance to any other client who has a problem with his laptop or PC. So I've created a security group called IT Helpdesk. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this, not to make any error in this, installing the name. So you place it here and then you click OK. You click apply and I click OK. So now we've created a remote assistant role. So we need to create a firewall role which will allow the remote assistant to work. So when you still need to go to the same group policy you've created there, and there you go to under computer configuration, you click policies, you click Windows settings, and here we have security settings. And now we are interested in Windows firewall with advanced security. Then we see the Windows firewall with advanced security. Then click the inbound roles. So here we are going to create three roles which will allow us to offer remote unsolicited remote assistance. So the first role we are going to create is a program roles. Select program and click next. So which program do you want to allow? Under which part is it? So for mine, I've actually copied it right somewhere. Just copy it and place it there. Sorry, let me see. Let me try it once more. No, I think I made a mistake somewhere. Okay. Well, let's just write down the rules. I think it's not a Windows directory. Be on a system 32, and then we're looking for the MS Microsoft Remote Assistant Project Executive. Click next. So it's now asking allow this the connection. Click next. It's for a domain environment, not for private or public environment. So you have to give your policy a role. I will just call mine allow MS Microsoft Remote Assistant. Click finish. So now let's create the second role, which is also a program. Click next, and we're also going to tap the second role. It's also in system 32 / and it's the next, allow the connection. It's also for a domain environment. You click type allow, click finished. So for the third role is actually a port role, which is the TCP 135 role. So this time we need to select port instead of programs. Click next. You specific local ports, and that is correct, is port 135. Click next. So it's gonna ask us we should allow the connection not to block it. So my domain environment, click next. And say allow TCP 135. Click finish. So now we've created this role. So what we actually need to do now is to create a role which is called the user's access control, because this role allow the user also to actually accept or deny you when you try to connect to his PC. So this role actually is also located under the computer configuration. You go to policies, Now, Windows settings, we are looking for security settings, and here we're going to look for the local policies, and here look for security options. So what we are looking for in this role is, let me see, users, let me see, yeah, users account control, and then allow the UI access application to prompt for elevation without using. Let's see. So you enable this role. So when you need more explanation about the just access control, you just click the explain, and here you get more information about what the role is talking about. So click apply and then click OK. So now we are done for this role. So what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to close this group policy management. As you can see, the role has been created. You click settings, you'll see all the roles you just created right now. So okay, now let me close the group policy again once more. I close Active Directory also computers. So now I'm going to my client PC. As you can see, Thomas is logged on to this PC, and Thomas is a member of the IT help desk. So what we are going to do, we are going to start, but in the first place, you know, when you create a policy, so you need to restart your PCs for your PCs to be able to have, for that policy to be able to take effect in your PCs, or it will take about 90 minutes for that policy to take effect. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to just apply the roles GP update on all my system. So I know, and it is my second client PC, and it is my Windows 7 client PC. Okay. So now what we do, okay, the rules have been completed successfully, it says. So when you go to Windows search on your client PC, it's that MSRA, and then you see the Microsoft Remote Assistant. So click on it. And what we are interested in, not invite someone you trust to help you, but help someone who has invited you. So you click on this, and here you have two options: use an invitation file or use Easy Connect. But we are more interested in this role here, this here. So we are going to use this role, okay, and then click this role. Yes. So now we're going to type in the PC of the client we want to connect to, or the host name. So what I actually do is, if you don't know the PC, the name of the PC, the IP address of the PC or the laptop, you can ask the user to use the command prompt or with the network properties to find its IP address. So for this IP address, which is 192.168.7.13, so I already have it here, and just type in that IP address and then you click next. So it's trying to connect, as you can see. Now the user is going to receive a message which says Thomas Johnson is trying to connect to your PC. So after connecting, Thomas Johnson will be able to see whatever is on your desktop. So do you want to allow Thomas Johnson to connect to your PC? So I'll say yes, and as you can see, you can now see what Nora Johnson is doing. So if I want to take a total full control of the laptop or desktop of Nora, what I will do is this: I will ask for request control, and Nora Johnson will receive a message that I want to take control of his laptop. She will say yes. I will go back to my laptop. At this moment, I should be able to take total control of the laptop of Nora Johnson. So as you can see, Nora Johnson is not there. That is for this. Okay, let me stop the sharing for now. Okay. But if you're an IT help desk and you have thousands of laptops or desktop you normally need to control, or even think server, or I think for server environments you would prefer to use the remote desktop connection. But what you want to do, you want to create a shortcut on your desktop, because the shortcut will give you an easy access to just start the Microsoft Remote Assistant instead of going to tap it on the search button of Windows. So what I'm going to do is this. On your desktop, right click on your desktop, click New, and then you click Shortcut. So what we are going to do is this. We're going to tap the rows on our Windows, on the environment, on our system 32. This on the program I'm looking for is, that is it. Then /. Of system. So it's very, very important that you add this to the offer remote assistant. If not, it's not going to work. So what I'm going, you have to give your shortcut a name. I'm just going to give it offer remote assistant. To finish, as you can see, there's a shortcut to the MS Arrow application file. So just double click on it, and here you go, you have all the IP address want to connect to. So I hope this video have been a great help to you if you work in an enterprise or a domain environment, or you are trying to just test it out and see if it works. So please, if this is a very good help to you, you can as well like my video or send me a message. Thank you very much.